Let us learn about arrays. What are arrays? Arrays are one of the types of reference type. In our previous videos, we must have learned what are the primitive data types and what are non-primitive data types. So one of the non-primitive data type is arrays. What exactly an array is, how it is useful, let us learn about it. An array is nothing but a fixed number of elements. Elements here is nothing but fixed number of values that an array will hold. You can declare a variable, for an example, anything, an integer type, where you say a is equal to 10. Therefore, a will be holding only one value of integer type. What if you want one variable to hold number of values or collection of values under one variable? How is it possible? It is possible through the use of an array. An array has a fixed value, right? If you see, provides a data structure called an array which stores a fixed sequence of elements, fixed sequence of values. That is, you declare that we have an array type. You need to provide what an array type is, that is a data type. An array is holding a value of integer type, and this integer type variable will hold 4 values, 5 value, 6 value, and so on that you would want to mention. One important concept or a rule about array is that if you want to fetch a value of an array which is at third position, how would you call? So in an array, every value is stored in its indices. That is, a value in variable of an array starts from 0. For an example, in a variable of an array, you are holding 10 values, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So these values will be stored in index starting from 0. Therefore, the first value would be stored in index 0, 1 will be stored in so on and so on until 10. Therefore, the 10th value would be stored in index 9. And it becomes easy for you to call a value which is in the third position by just writing the array name and the index name, and you will be able to call the value that you would want on a particular point. So here we say, how can we declare an array? We'll see the syntax. We write the data type, that is your array, which is going to hold some amount of values. What kind of a value it is? Is it of a double type? Is it a string? Is it integers? What type it is, you need to provide that. So once you provide the data type, you provide your array name, just like my array or any array that is the common name or the name which is visible, you can provide, followed with a semicolon. The other way to write would be the data type, array name and then the brackets. What is the difference between these two? There is as such no difference in execution. Both of them will work in your Java program, but the recommended way to write an array or create an array is the data type, brackets and the array name. This bracket says that we will hold the number of values. Let us see an example. We have written here an example. The data type is double, it will hold the values, and the array name is my list. Next, here we understand what are the other ways you can write an array. See, first you create an array, then you need to store certain values in those array. You need to initialize those array. How will you do? So let us learn. It says that we have created here a variable equals to new data type and the array size. This new keyword will help you to create a new array of this particular type and this particular size. It may be string type. For an example, you're trying to create an array of this particular data type, that may be int, and sizes 10, 20, whatever you would want to give. And then the reference of this array will be stored in this variable with the help of new keyword. What is this variable? Let us understand. Till now we know that a variable can be of an int or a string type which will hold a certain single value. But if you want to hold certain sequence of values, then you need to create a variable which is an array reference. So how do you declare? You provide the data type, then in the brackets, then you write the name of the array equals to new data type. This data type should be the same of this data type, because you're creating an array reference and storing in this variable, and that array is of this particular size. So example, you can give, you write int brackets my list equal to new int and mindless size is 10. Next, it says that how can you assign the values if you want to provide. Now, you say your array size is 10, but you want to provide the values as 1, 2, 3 or 10, 20, 30, any value to this array. How would you do that? You would provide your data type, brackets, your array name equals to so and so. One way to declare array is to provide the data type, array name, and directly you provide the value. The other way, if you just want to declare the array and later initialize, then you can declare an array with the size and then you call the array name in the brackets to provide the value. In this example, we'll see how can you understand about the indices, an array, its size and the values associated. So we have taken this example where we have listed out 10 values starting from index 0, 1, 2, 3 and till 9. Although you have 10 values, the index in array starts with 0. So you have an array created of a double type. You write double brackets, then the array name, which is my list, equals to new double, that is a data type similar to the variable that you are referring to. So you write double and in the brackets you provide what is the size of your array. So in our example, we have created an array of a size 10. Now what will this 10 will hold the values? We need to define that. So we say at index 1 the array value will be this, at index 2 it will be so and so. From 0 to 9 you define what is the value. Now when you provide or when you are trying to add at index 10, it will not allow you to store any value because your array size is limited to 10. And now let us see here, we have my list. How do you assign the value? My list is your array name. In the bracket you provide from index 0 is equal to so and so, my list again in the bracket index 1 so and so. So this will help you to call or get the value from a particular location. If you are trying to fetch the value of an array at index 4, it will directly go here, get the value and give you back. You will not have to go and search like where is this, where is that. What happens? It goes sequentially searching for index 4 and once it gets, it will return you the value. So these are the few array methods which are available to work better on arrays. How you can sort if you have a sequence of elements in an array. Every value in an array are termed as an element. So when you want to sort these elements, you may have provide the value like 30, 40, 10, 11 and not in sequence, right? Those are not sorted. If you want to sort them in ascending or descending, you can use certain sort method. For example, you have another two methods, like you have two arrays, array 1 and array 2. Array 1 has certain variables and array 2 has certain elements, right? So now you want to check whether the elements in each of these array are equal or not. So again you have another method for comparison. And if you want to search a particular key and an object, you use your binary search method. The next, it says that if you want to provide a particular value at particular index, for an example, you have created an array with size 5 and you have provided value for index 0, 1, 4 and 5 and not for 3. And if you want to provide the value at index 3, then you can fill the value with this particular value that you provide. So let us see here in an example how you can work with an array. You create an array name double my list. So your double is the data type, then in the brackets the array name equals to, in the curly braces you provide the values separating commas. If it was an integer type int, then you would have written 1, 2, 3, whatever the values you want to pass. Because it is in double, we are writing in decimals. If you wanted to traverse the elements of string type, then you would have written here string and then given the names or whatever data you would want. If you're traversing the country name, you could have written India, Australia, US and so in inverted commas and then separating with a comma. Finally, you end with a semicolon. So in this case, we have declared an array and initialized an array with certain values. The first one, it says that we are trying to print the values which are available in an array. How you can do that? We can use a for loop to reiterate until unless the number of times is met. Remember, a for loop is used if you want to iterate or execute a block of statement for a particular number of times. So we have used here a for loop. We have initialized a value equal to 0, and this I will traverse the each and every element of an array until its length is met. And what is the method? You write the array name dot length. So until I is greater than length, please keep printing the value of I. What is the value of I here? The I value is nothing but it will get or traverse the elements of an array and get each and every value one by one and then print. And how, where it is stored? It is stored in my list. So you write the array name and the variable which is holding the value at that index. So we say that at index 0, what is the value of my list? It says 1.9, so it will print that. Next, it will go and search my list of 1. Why 1? Because earlier the value of I was 0 and now the I value is incremented by 1. Therefore, it will go and search at the index 1 and print the rest value. Similarly, it will keep repeating until unless it meets the length or it is greater than length. For now, 0, 1, 2, 3 indices it will print, and once it reaches 4, it will terminate and then it will come outside the loop. Next, we are trying to sum, or next we are trying to add the all the value of the elements and print the total value. All this could have also been done with the help of for enhanced loop. We have already covered what an enhanced loop is there. It is mainly used to traverse each and every element of an array, but we are here trying to use only a simple for loop for our understanding. Again, we have initialized a variable I equals to 0 because our index starts at 0. Then I will keep repeating the iteration until the length is met. And what it does, every time it gets the I value, it needs to store them. For an example, we have certain values 10, 20, 30 and we want to add them. What I do, I say my list of I, that is my list of index 0 is 10, please store it in total. Now total will temporarily have 10 in it. The next value that my list of I, that is at my list of index 1, will fetch 20, and this 20 will be added to total, where total is already 10. 10 plus 20, and this process repeats. So in this case, because we need certain variable to hold the value temporary, we create a variable outside, and this is of a double type because the value that we are trying to traverse and add are of double type. And then this value, every time, if you remember, this plus and equal to is nothing but that assignment operator, you can write total equal to total plus my list of I. So every time you get the value, you add it to total, and that total value would be added temporarily to total. And next time again you get the value, it will get summed up with that. And finally, it prints your sum of value of elements of an array. The next statement here we are trying to see is that what or which is the largest element among all the elements that we have provided in an array. If you remember, there is a mathematical function called max which is used to find out which is the max value. We create here an for loop where I will start traversing from 1, and then it says my list dot length I plus plus. It will keep repeating until unless it finds the max value. We are providing here a condition that my list of I, whatever at that index this array is holding value, is that greater than max. What is the max value here? What is at index 0? What you do is that first you need to hold certain value. If you want to compare whether this value is max or not, you need certain comparison. So what we are trying to do here is that we are trying to hold the index 0 value under a variable called max. And how do you get that value? You write the array name in the bracket index number. So this will hold the value max. So max is holding value 1.9. So now the next step would be to traverse each and every element to compare with the first element. Max has the value called 1.9. So your next step would be comparing, is 2.9 greater than 1.9? If not, it will go to next element. So how will you do that? You create a for loop and you start the traversing from index 1. Index 0 value is already at max, so you are trying to compare from index 1, right? And you will traverse till the length of an array is meant, and you keep incrementing. That is, you keep moving index from 0 to 1, 1 to 2 and so on. It says that if the value which is there in index I, that is 1 that you have fetched, which is 2.9, if that is greater than max, that is if 2.9 is greater than 1.9, then please save that value as max and then print. If not, go back, reiterate, get the next value of I, that is 3.4. It will check if 3.4 is greater than 1.9, and this process keeps repeating until the max value is found. So array is one of the very important concept where you want to fetch a particular value, or when you want to sort the values, or when you are trying to traverse the values through its elements, through its indices. Therefore, an array will help you to store a fixed value and to get or traverse the values one by one, that is in sequence. So let us run this program practically for our better understanding. In this example, we are trying to create array that may be an array of characters, array of integers, array of doubles and so on. So let us see what are the ways that you can first declare an array, initialize an array, how can you store the values in it. So how can you declare an array? To declare an array, you write what kind of an array it is supposed to be, whether it's supposed to be a string of arrays, int of arrays, double of arrays, char of arrays, that you need to define, then followed with the brackets and then the variable name and colon. This is how you declare an array. So you have a variable which is of an array type, array of characters, is created. But how do you allocate memory to this array? That is, how much memory or fixed memory that you want to locate for this particular variable, which is my array. So we write my array equal to new, which is type of again a char, that is character, and the value is 5. So we are trying to hold or allocate memory of 5 characters for this particular array. Now we will try initializing the value, that is, we'll try storing the value to each of its index. So first index where the variable name is my array. So in array, the index starts with 0 and so on. So at 0, we are trying to save a character h, at index 1, e and so on. The first thing that we will do is we will try printing the particular element in that particular index. So we are printing system.out.println my array. In the brackets, you need to provide the index number for which value you would want to display. If I write here as 0, it will print h, because at index 0, h is stored. If I write here as 1, then it will print the value which is stored at index 1 and so on. What if you want to print the complete array, that is, complete the value of array that is stored in char, that is LO. So what do you write? System.out.println and then the variable name in which the values are stored. First we have seen an array of characters. Now let us see an array of double, where you store the value which is in a double format. So the other way to create an array would be the data type brackets variable name equals to, you initialize or you provide the value in the curly braces and followed with a comma, after the curly braces provide a semicolon. Let us now print these values. One way to print the value is directly providing my list. The other way, if you would want to print one value at a time and then following the next value, we can try using a for loop. We have already learned how a for loop works. It has three parameters. One, where you initialize a variable. Second, you provide a condition. And third, when the loop is supposed to be stopped. So the first, you initialize a variable I, providing a value 0. And then the condition is, if I is less than my list dot length. So here your length of list would be read. That is, the length of your list is
1, 2, 3, 4. So if I is less than 5, then please keep increment the value of I and print the value which is there in my list. Okay, again I repeat, I is 0 and if I is less than the length of my list, which is 1, 2, 3, 4 in case of my list. So here 0 is less than 4, then please go and print the value of my list of I. That is my list of I, and in I the value of the first variable will be stored. That is the value of variable my list 1.9 will be stored. Then it comes back to the loop and increment the value of I, which will become 1. Now 1 is less than my list dot length, that is 1 less than 4. So the next value of my list will be stored in I and print. Therefore the rest of the values would be printed. We will see the output when we execute the program. Third, we have tried creating an array of integers. Int bracket the variable name equal to the values in the braces separated by commas and following a semicolon. What if you want to print the sum of these values? For now you have seen how to print an array in a single line, how to read an array in another variable and print one at a time, and now we will see how can you print the sum of the values of an array. So here we again take a for loop. We initialize I equal to 0. I should read my list dot length I plus plus and print the values. But what we want is that every time it prints the value, it should save that value somewhere, and when it comes next time, it should add to the new value. In this case, the first value is 1. So my list of I, that is 1, will be stored in total, right? So what is this total? It should hold some value which may be of int type, double type, float type. So we have just taken a variable called double. So this value of my list I, which is 1, will temporarily be stored in total as 1. Therefore the total value is 1. Because we need the sum of the arrays, we need to provide a condition where total plus value of I, like we write C equal to C plus A, it is similar to that. Now next in loop, when it comes, the my list dot length value would be 2. Therefore the I value here is 2. So 2 plus 1, which was already stored in total, will be added, that is 3, and will be saved in total. Again it goes back to loop, get the next value which is 3, then add this 3 plus the temporary value which was in total and save the value in this total and return. So on, the process continues. Once the condition is met, it prints the value of total. Let us now save this program and execute. So here you see the first one tries printing the value of an array which is at index 1, and index 1 is your this. It should print E. The second, you are trying to display your complete array, you are trying to print your complete array, that is LO. Third, you are trying to retrieve what is the length of your array, that is 5. In next case, where it is an array of double, you were trying to print one value at a time and in the next line. Lastly, you were trying to add all the integers or the sum of integers and display your total, that is 15.